Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we're going to do a simple dolly zoom on a still image. So last week I did a tutorial on how to create a super subtle dolly zoom with a video, and I'll leave a card. But this week we're going to do this with an image. So I have this image of this child, and I'm just going to make a new composite shot. I will go 5 seconds. And I will drag the picture of her in, and if I right-click, I can go ahead and transform fit to frame width so that it is fitting the width. It's still a little bit taller, but that's okay. Here's the thing. Most pictures, obviously, are bigger than 1920 by 1080. This one is no exception, so you shouldn't have any issue with resolution when it comes to doing this on a picture. What I'm going to do is right-click on this and duplicate it. On the front one, I'm going to create a fairly loose mask. You can be as detailed as you like around this, but because of the way that I'm going to do this, it will be fairly easy to hide the mask itself. So take your time and do it well, or just pretty loosely like I'm doing here this way. And now we have a foreground picture and a background picture. The foreground picture, we're going to open up the transform properties, and we are going to check the scale. And then if we go to the end, I can just increase the size of that, maybe, 10% or so. So now it's just sort of expanding, looking almost like a dolly zoom, right? So, but you can tell that it's fairly disconnected here, right, where her hair is and things like that. That's okay. First thing we'll do is we will hide it a little bit by feathering the mask, and I'll just give it a little bit of a feather to taste, of course. And then we are going to look for the zoom blur effect, and I'm going to drop that on the background picture first. And if I open it up, I can tick on keyframing for that, start at zero, go to the end, and then I'm just going to go into the negatives as much as I feel like I can, to sort of get that trombone effect. And I think I will focus that on her nose this way. I'm going to go ahead and right-click on it, copy it, and I'm just going to paste that into the child. But the child, I'm going to change, instead of going into the negatives, I'm going to go actually a little bit into the positive instead, okay? Maybe like that much. Not as much as I did to the negative side. And when you're done, you have something that looks like this. It's a pretty easy effect to do. Doesn't require a whole lot. I want to thank Dafter Things for requesting this tutorial. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.